most lovable and adorable person. She has been blessed with the power to nurture a complete life in her womb with intense love and care. And we must articulate our love and respect for the role she plays in our life. Let us now listen to a short conversation between two friendly mothers, Neela and Sarita.
Hi, Sarita. Hi. I have not seen you for a long time.
Hi, Neela.
I'm well. How are you? You look happy. What is the reason for that broad smile?
I got a raise and a promotion. I'm so happy in my workplace.
Wow. I'm very happy for you. How I wish to go to office, but with my two kids and family to take care, I have no time looking for a job.
Don't worry, Sarita. I will help you. Don't you know our neighbor, Varsha? She too has kids and is contributing to society in her own way. There are many women like her who are taking care of their homes and providing benevolent service. Let us hear to some few success stories.
In 1994, an 18-year-old tall and confident lass was crowned Miss Universe. With this feat, she became the first Indian woman to clinch the revered title. Since then, she accomplished a lot in life, inspired many single moms, and proved that if one is determined enough, nothing can stop them from achieving their life goals. On her experience as a mother, she says it was magical, tough, complicated, and very human. She adopted her first daughter, Renee, when she was 24, and another daughter, Eliza. Despite the tough court rules that only a son can be adopted after a daughter, she is someone who broke away from the conformist mold and won the court fight to move on with her second adoption of Eliza. She has taught her daughters to believe in themselves, be courageous, and take independent decisions in life. Her mantra is, love your children unconditionally. As a mother, it should not matter to you if the child comes out of your womb or your heart. She is Sushmita Sen, a shining example of nurturing elegance. A sportswoman who has made India proud with a glorious achievement, Mary Kom is the only Indian woman boxer who managed to qualify for the 2012 Summer Olympics, where she also won a bronze medal. A five-time world amateur boxing champion, she is surprisingly serene and philosophical about all her achievements. Born into a poor family, she began helping her parents by working in the field while still very young. As a school girl, she used to play a variety of sports but was inspired to take up boxing, which was not an easy task for a young tribal girl. But Mary was not someone to be discouraged and traveled to Imphal to train in athletics. Today her success is for all to see. Of course, there is more to Mary Kom than just professional success. With three sons in her stash, she also teaches boxing to the underprivileged youngsters for free. She says, don't let anyone say you are weak because you are a woman. I admire this tiger mom as she is an inspirational figure.
Who devoted her life to serving the poor and destitute around Singapore.
Mother Teresa awarded the Nobel Peace Prize and became a symbol of charitable selfless work. In 2016, Mother Teresa was canonized by the Roman Catholic Church as Saint Teresa of Calcutta. Mercifully, against abortion, she would urge women, keep your heart from the killing of your child. Give me your child and I will give the child to a family that loves and cares for her. She is fondly remembered as the mother of the destitute, truly innocent.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Pala Brahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Guru means darkness and Ru means remover. Guru is the enlightenment principle that aids in the realization of the true self. As we celebrate motherhood, let us remember some contribution of the first woman teacher, Savitri Bai Phule, who was a social worker and a poet. She is credited by laying the foundation in education opportunities for women in India. She played a major role in the struggle of women's rights during the British rule. Many of her poems were against discrimination and spoke about the need to get educated. She campaigned against untouchability, Sakti tradition, child marriage and upliftment of the poor. Her husband Jyoti Rao Phule educated her at home and trained her how to become a teacher. They both dedicated their lives for equality between men and women. Now the girls of grade 1E will rhythmically move to some melodies expressing adulation for all such women.
Yeah. Bye-bye.